Здравствуйте, товарищи, and welcome to our 7th day of our Month of Mod celebration. And today I'm bringing you a pretty epic mod for one of everybody's favorite time sinks, Mountain Blade Warband. And to be a great mod, sometimes you don't really need to change the structure or look of the game. You just need to take what the game's core is and perhaps take it to its logical conclusion, which is exactly what our mod today does, a mod called 1257 AD. Now, I love the Mountain Blade series, but I haven't really had the opportunity to check out many mods, and I guess that's because when I tried to download some mods for the first time, basically what happened was that my computer crashed and my game froze and it just was a general pain in the ass and things didn't go so well. However, with the celebration and project that we're doing today, it's given me the opportunity to come back and check out some of these Mountain Blade mods. So all the Mountain Blade mods that are going to appear on this list are fan recommended because, like I said, I'm not familiar with that modding community. So I just want to preface this by saying that I haven't had a ton of opportunity to really play through this mod. I've given it a good 5 or 6 hours by the time of recording this, but when you're coming to a Mountain Blade game, you really gotta sink 50 or 60 hours into it to really understand all the intricacies that may have been added into it. So if I miss something about the mod, it's because I haven't had the chance to experience it to its full extent. Anyway, onwards to the mod itself, and the mod itself tries to pride itself in historical realism, so as a result, you're not going to be playing in the fictional Mountain Blade universe, but instead you're thrust into the continent of Europe in 1257 AD. So rather than having a choice of 5 or 6 factions that you can play as, you now have a choice of upwards of 30 different states that you can pledge your allegiance to. So just to name a few different factions you can choose from. There's the Kingdom of France, the Kingdom of England, the Kingdom of Scotland, the Holy Roman Empire, the Kingdom of Sweden, the Mongol Empire, the Republic of Novgorod. What else do we got? We got the Roman Empire of Nicaea, the Mameluke Sultanate, the Ilkhanate, and many, many more. Now, all these different kingdoms and peoples and nations have their own units, and while there is some overlap between, say, Western European kingdoms, they'll have similar units, and Middle Eastern kingdoms will have similar units to one another, I think the developers did a pretty good job in making every faction seem fairly distinct. Of course, with these new units comes tons of new items that are much more historically accurate and relevant than the items in the original game. So, take your English army for example. It'll be equipped with similar armor and weapon types to that of a historically accurate English army of the era. Or your basic French army, or Holy Roman Empire army, or Mongol army, and so on and so forth. On top of that, the mod tries to add in period accurate figures and lords and kings and other types of people, giving it yet another layer of historical accuracy. Then, when you combine this with the fact that there are more quests to do, there are more cities to visit, there are more things to buy, people to kill, castles to own, you've got a pretty substantial upgrade on the already awesome Mountain Blade experience. The selling point for this mod really is the historical accuracy, and to me that improves the Mountain Blade experience because I don't like fictional worlds so much, I don't like fictional factions so much, with the only exception really being the Game of Thrones universe. But generally speaking, I like it when things are based more in history and based more in reality, because that lets me create scenarios which I can have more of a connection to, because I can base those connections on things that actually happened, and therefore that makes my experience more enjoyable. And that's what I really liked about the mod 1257 AD. So if you haven't already sunken in enough time to Mountain Blade Warband, I would definitely recommend you check out 1257 AD. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the 7th day of our Month of Mods celebration, and until tomorrow, this has been Joseph Vizranovic Stalin, signing off for now, and I'll see you guys later.